Solve for x. 3/4 x plus 1/3 equals 8. So first thing I'm going to do here is subtract 1/3 from both sides. So I'm going to get 3/4 x and 1/3 minus 1/3 is 0 equals 8 minus 1/3. To combine the 8 and the 1/3, I need to have a common denominator. So I'm going to multiply the 8 times 3 over 3, which equals 8 times 3, which is 24, divided by 1 times 3, which is 3. So now I can say I have 3/4 x equals 24/3 minus 1/3. So 3/4 x equals 24 minus 1, which is 23, over 3. To finish solving, multiply by the reciprocal of 3/4, which is 4/3, and I'll put a 4/3 here. And it doesn't really matter which side I put the 4/3 on. I wrote it on the left here. I put it to the right of the 22/3, but because multiplication is commutative, you can switch the order and it doesn't matter. So it's fine here. So let's see, 4 times 3 is 12, 3 times 4 is 12, x equals 23 times 4. Carry the 1, that's 92/3. 12 divided by 12 is 1, so x equals 92/3. That's kind of a weird number. I'm not sure, you know, what that represents. So I'm going to divide by 3 and make it a mixed number. So 92 divided by 3. 3 goes into 9 3 times. So 3 times 3 is 9. Then subtract. We get 0, bring down the 2. 2 times 3 is 0. 0 times 3 is 0. We have 2 for a remainder. So it's 30 and then 2/3 left over. So x equals 30 and then 2/3. Now the other way to solve this would be multiply through by the least common multiple. 4 times 3 is 12. So let me show you how that works. We'll have 12 times 3/4 x and then plus 12 times 1/3 equals 12 times 8. And I'll put these over 1 here. So 12 times 3 is 36. 1 times 4 is 4, and then times x, plus 12 times 1 is 12, divided by 1 times 3, which is 3, equals 12 times 8. Well, let's see, 12 times 8, 2 times 8 is 16, carry the 1. 1 times 8 is 8, plus 1 is 9, so 96. Let's simplify. 36 divided by 4 is 9, so it's going to be 9x, plus 12 divided by 3, which is 4, equals 96. To finish solving, subtract 4 from both sides. So 9x equals 96 minus 4, which is 92. And then divide by 9 on both sides. So I simplify and get 9 divided by 9 is 1, so x equals 92/9. That's interesting. We had 92/9 here, and we have 92/3 here, so there's a mistake somewhere. Let me look back, see if I can find it. And you know what? Everybody makes math mistakes sometimes. It's all right. Okay, let me look right here at this step. 23 times 4, that is 92, but I forgot to multiply 3 times 3, which is 9. So this should have been 92/9 right here. That's where my mistake was. Okay, so this should be 92/9. So this isn't right. I'm going to take my 92/9 and divide that out. So 9 goes into 9 once. 1 times 9 is 9. 9 minus 9 is 0. Bring down the 2. 9 does not go into 2. 0 times 9 is 0, so we're going to have a 2 here. So your answer is actually going to be the 10 and then 2/9. So here's a really interesting example. I made a mistake when I was working through the problem, but by doing the problem a separate way, I was able to find the mistake because I got two different answers using two techniques. Should have given the same answer. So how could I have avoided this? If I was only using one technique, I could have checked my answer. If I put my 32/3 back in here and used a calculator to figure out the complicated fraction calculation, I would have found that this probably doesn't equal 8. So that's a really good example of why you should check your answers. Or you could try the problem two different ways and see if you get the same answer each time.